We're here to help you protect your organisation against cyber threats. The Victorian Government Cyber Maturity Benchmark is an annual assessment of your organisation's cybersecurity controls, which uses the Australian Cybersecurity Centre's Essential 8 Maturity Model. In this hub, you'll also be able to find other assessments and tools. By completing the assessment, you'll be able to identify gaps and improve your organisation's cyber maturity. You'll also see how your organisation compares to other agencies with benchmarking data. We've broken down the steps you need to take. You can also skip to the sections relevant to you using the timestamps in the description of the video below. Step 1. Access the benchmark assessment via the Self-Assessment Hub. If you're new to the Self-Assessment Hub, you'll receive a welcome email with a link and login details. Once you've logged in, you'll be asked to create a new password. If you're an existing user, you can access the hub from our website, vmia.vic.gov.au/cyber-maturity-benchmark. Then, click into the Cyber Benchmark portal. Enter your agency's name and select it from the drop-down menu. Log in with your username and password. Step 2. Completing an assessment. From the homepage, there are two ways to get to the assessment page. Under Recent Assessments, click on the Homepage button and the Campaign page will appear. Alternatively, you can click on the Assessments tab, select the assessment and the Campaign page will appear. Click on Enter Assessment to begin. The assessment contains 8 questions. Select the appropriate level of maturity that best describes your organisation. If you need some help deciding or understanding each level, there's also a detailed description of the control at the top of the screen and a description of the relevant control maturity for each of the levels under the Essential 8. You can also refer to extra resources via the link in the notice board section. Once you've chosen your current and desired maturity levels in the assessment, select your coverage and assurance ratings. We've included 4 questions for each of the 8 control areas to help you in assessing the effectiveness of your controls. Simply select the option from the drop-down menu which most accurately represents the arrangements for each type of control. Enter any additional or explanatory notes. For example, you can add information about why the maturity level was chosen for a control area, as well as notes about coverage and assurance. You can check your progress of the assessment in the menu on the left. A red or orange tick, depending on your current or desired maturity, will display for each question you've answered, and for any unanswered questions, a grey bar will appear. Your changes are automatically saved at each step, as long as you're connected online. To exit the assessment at any time, scroll down and click on Assessment Homepage. Once you've completed the assessment, the following message will appear. Click the OK button to proceed and you can review your responses and access reporting. If for any reason the completed assessment message doesn't appear, you may have missed a question. Step 3. Viewing results and benchmarking. Your results will display on the dashboard. Here you can see your overall score, with current and desired scores and coverage and assurance ratings for each of the 8 controls. To view your dashboard, click on the Assessments tab. Click on the assessment and the Campaign page will appear. From here, click My Dashboard. Click on Benchmarking to retrieve benchmarking data. You can also filter the results. If you hover over the graphs or legends, it will display a description. You can also download a PDF of the data. Click the Export to PDF and follow the prompts. Step 4. Generating reports. There are 2 reports you can generate from the Reports tab. 1. An executive summary report, which is designed for a board or committee report, or 2. A detailed responses report, which contains a summary of each response from your assessment. To continue in each of the menus, select Essential 8 Maturity Model, Victorian Government Cyber Maturity Benchmark, and Live Data. From here, you can export the report in your preferred format. Step 5. Different user roles. There are 3 types of user roles: senior user, user, and read-only user. Senior users usually coordinate and complete the assessment. They can also add other users, reset passwords, change roles, deactivate users, and change the primary contact. You can have more than one senior user, however, just remember that only one user can be a primary contact with VMIA. A user can contribute to an assessment, whereas a read-only user can view the assessment and reporting only. Step 6. Performing admin requests. To make any user changes, you'll need to be a senior user. To add another user, select New User from the menu on the left. Add their full name, title, and contact number. In the Privilege Level field, select Senior User, User, or Read Only. Enter their email address and check that the User Active field is on. Before clicking the Create User button, check the Password and Send Email Notification boxes. An email will be sent to the user with their login details. You may also need to check your junk folder. To reset a password, click the user's name and their profile will appear. Click the Confirm Password Reset checkbox, then click Reset Password. To manually change a password, click the user's name and when their profile appears, enter a new password and select Confirm Password Change. Remember to inform the user that you've updated their password as they won't receive a notification. To change a role for a user, click into their user profile and select a role from the Privilege Level field. Click Save Changes to confirm. To deactivate a user, from their user profile, slide the User Active toggle to off. Confirm by clicking Save Changes. The user will be deactivated immediately. To find out more, contact us. If you have any questions about the Victorian Government's Cyber Maturity Benchmark, visit our website at vmia.vic.gov.au/cyber-maturity-benchmark.